Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2240A, Threaded Comments. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's podcast is really cool, but I need to caution you about something, all right? And down in the YouTube description down there, there are hyperlinks to these. This one in red is really important. So first, I'm going to show you the new threaded comments, but they don't make it clear that the old and new comments are allowed to coexist. And we're going to talk about why you might want to keep your legacy comments. And once you understand that, that when they offer to convert your old comments to threaded comments, that's permanent. And you need to avoid that if I can convince you to keep the old legacy comments. And then we'll talk about how to use the legacy comments. And then also for the new threaded comments, what the VBA looks like. It's going to be a long video. Again, down here in the YouTube description, you'll have hyperlinks to each of those, particularly this one in red. All right, part one. These new threaded comments are really cool. They're back here on the review tab. These icons, brand new icons, they look like the old icons. They're not. It's a completely new thing. I'm on a new comment here. Get the rods, not the tiny pretzels, please. I can either press Control Enter or that little green send icon. If I just press Enter, it goes to a new line in the comment, which is cool, I guess. But it's been driving me crazy because I keep forgetting to press Control Enter. Beautiful things. It marks the date and the time when I created the comment. I can go back and edit the comment without a hassle. Now, here's a few that I created earlier today. All right, so I asked half gallon or quart, skimmer 2%. The other computer, this is my dog's computer, Daisy and Bella, they said half gallon at 2%. I said this at 9:10, they said it at 9:19. I can't change the time, but I can go back and edit what I said. And then I said they only have a gallon. All right, so that's the whole theory with the threaded comments. We can actually have a conversation. It's almost like a chat panel, you know, but not quite. Right, it's more permanent than a chat panel. This is all great. You can also say that you want to show all comments or click this comments, and then we get this great little panel over here on the right hand side. And in theory, the way that this is supposed to work is when I click the cell, it takes me to that comment. It definitely takes me down to the last comment, and even if I go to ice cream, I kind of get it, but if I go all the way up to milk, for some reason, it is not going to the top. And that's probably just some sort of a weird bug, and that'll probably get fixed. Again, this just came out yesterday, version 1809, build 10820-206. So we're really early in this feature. But I wanted to show you the feature because it's a cool feature. Part 2. Threaded comments are allowed to coexist. This is an old comment created in Excel 2013. I'm allowed to have those there and add a new style comment. All right, so there's absolutely no hassle with having both sets of comments in the workbook. No problem at all. All right, so here's the same workbook in Excel 2013. The comment indicators are there. Threaded comment. This threaded comment can be what? Let's show that comment. Click on the comment and make it larger. Can be viewed, but not edited in your version of Excel. Learn more. And then down here, they finally get to the comment. Oh, this is bad. Now, I can actually come in here and edit this, but if I edit it, it'll be lost when I go back to Office 365. All right, now here are the particular reasons why you might want to consider keeping your legacy comments. The first few are going to be really popular. You're on Office 365 and your coworkers are not. Or you have coworkers use Excel online, this story is going to get better, but right now, today, August 31st, not working yet. Or you take files home and your home computer's not on Office 365, right? Those are the really common reasons to stay, but there's other reasons to stay. Let me scroll down here. Did you used to do this where you created beautiful little directions for people? You change the color and shape of the comment and you show all comments? New comments can't do this. If you use this trick frequently, you're going to want to stay with the old legacy comments. And then, some really rare things. If you're a fan of the late, great Dave Holly from Osgrid, and you used his trick from the Excel Hacks book to either create pop-up pictures or star-shaped comments. The new comments certainly won't do that. Now look, hey, there's already a new comment in this sheet and these are coexisting, so it's not that they're going away. I was afraid that all my favorite tricks there are going away, but they're not going away. It's possible to coexist. Now hey, look, kudos to the threaded comment team. I love this feature and I hate to be a Debbie Downer, but I'm going to be a Debbie Downer. If you need any of those reasons to use the old comments, be really careful, because if you come here and try and edit this comment and right click and say reply to comment, then they give you this horrible message. This is a one-time message. It will convert every comment in the workbook and there's no way back. Well, if you're in Office 365, you could go back. If you're in Office 365 saving to the OneDrive, you can go back. But if you're not, this permanently loses everything. And I don't really like that they're not being clear with us that there are other ways to go. Again, remember, the new style comments and the old style comments can coexist. If you use any of those methods in the last part of the video, then you don't want to convert. All right, again, August 31st, 2018, if you want to use the old legacy comments, you're going to have to go through this set of steps. I'm at File, Options, Customize Ribbon, creating a new group here. I'm going to rename it to be Notes. I'm going to call it Notes. That's what comments used to be called, Notes, and I'm going to move that up to right after Comments. All right, so now that I have Notes, now I'm going to go through and find several commands, and there's a bunch. All right, so I'm going to find New Edit Comment Legacy. Next Comment Legacy. Previous Comment Legacy. Show Hide Comments Legacy. Show All Comments Legacy. And really, Previous Comment should be before Next Comment. Click OK. Review. And now we have Comments and we have Notes. At this point, it's really easy to add either. We can have the new comment with new comment. Or we can have an old comment, which I can resize, recolor, do anything I need to do. And I can even show all comments, which only shows the old comments, not the new comments. So look, once we have these new things up here and we open a workbook that was open in 2013, well then we have this button to new edit comment and I can edit without any hassle. But you see, that's hidden. That's hidden by default. If you don't go through that the steps of adding all this and you get one of these old style comments and you right click and see reply to comment, well then it's going to nag you to convert. Putting these up here allows you to coexist with Excel 2013 and Office 365, and clearly it's the way to go. All right, finally, the VBA story. It's new VBA to do these, so we'll record a macro. And first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new comment. So this is a new comment. Perfect. Then I'm going to go back and reply to that comment. Perfect. Oh, I screwed something up. Let me go back and edit the original comment. And then we'll add a reply number 2. And I screwed something up and I want to edit reply number 1. There we are. Stop recording. Let's go take a look at that code. All right. So, Range A1, dot add comment threaded. This is a new comment. And then to add a reply, comment threaded dot add reply. To edit the original comment, comment threaded dot text, and then text colon equals this is a new comment edited. To add a reply, this is reply number 2. All right, now, so remember we have comment, reply 1, reply 2, and then I went back and edited reply number 1. So that's comment threaded dot replies 1 dot text, and that's how we would edit in VBA. Simple enough, the old comment code will continue to work. There we are. Okay, threaded comments, they're cool. the old and new comments can coexist, although that's not obvious. There's a lot of reasons why you want to keep those legacy comments. And then watch out for this, converting to threaded comments is permanent. If you have a channel and you have viewers and you can reach people, please pass this note along. This is the important note. Once people convert from their old comments to the new threaded comments, it's really a problem. How to use legacy comments, add these notes back in. This one day will hopefully just be a button press to bring it back. And then took a look at the new comment VBA. I want to thank you for stopping by.
Come all you Excellers, if you want to hear a story about a clever trickster there. David Holly was the trickster's name. On a star-shaped comment, boy, he won his fame.
Excel super pros have been creating comments, documenting their spreadsheets for their bosses. Build 1809 brings you threaded comments, but your clueless co-workers will be mountain losses. When that manager clicks reply to comment, Excel 365 says just one moment. Click invert comment and no joy will bring. All your beautiful comments will lose their bling. Excel Pro, create a star-shaped comment. Clueless manager didn't read a thing. Excel Pro, create a star-shaped comment. And all your beautiful comments have lost their zing.
Hey, don't forget, on Tuesday, September 4th, it's the Excel Hash Game. Where OzSLA challenged 6 YouTube creators to create something out of 4 crazy ingredients. It's going to be a lot of fun. Look forward to that. Have a great weekend here in the United States. It's a long weekend. We'll see you on Tuesday.